Hey, what's going on, guys? So it has come to one of those fairly infrequent points in my life where I start to reevaluate some of the tools that I'm using to get my work done. And this time around, my critical eye has fallen on the apps that hold my thoughts and machinations. I like that word, it's a good word, machinations. Anyway, yes, it is time to talk about note-taking apps, because after about a full week of, let's be honest here, far more research than I should have done for this topic, I am now ready to present to you my top 10 note-taking apps in 2019. Now, before we dive in, I do want to talk a little bit about my criteria for this list. First, the apps on this list primarily use text as their input method because I can type a lot faster than I can write, and I want to be able to type and get data out at the speed at which I think. So while we're going to talk about apps like Evernote and OneNote, which can support drawing to an extent, we're not going to focus on apps that primarily use handwriting as their method of input, like NoteShelf 2 for the iPad. Plus, a lot of those apps have integrations with Evernote anyway. Secondly, every app I'm going to talk about here has some form of cross-platform availability. Not every app on the list is available on every platform, but nothing on this list is available on only one OS. And finally, criteria number three, which I find to be the most important criteria, I don't think an app is a note-taking app unless it combines its note-taking or editor area with its UI for browsing files or notes. I think this is crucial for a note-taking app because I'm constantly referencing different notes, searching for things, and I want to have all that available in one window. So that means apps like Google Docs and Microsoft Word and Dropbox Paper are all not going to make the cut here, though I do have to admit that Dropbox Paper in particular has probably the best writing experience in a writing app that I've ever tried, though we do have one app on this list that does come very close to that level of greatness, so stay tuned for that app. Before we get to that one though, we do have to go through the other entries on my list, and where better to start than with Evernote. Ah yes, Evernote, the granddaddy of syncing note-taking apps. I have been using Evernote for darn near 9 years at this point, and I have to admit that it's a very powerful tool that I basically can't get myself to break away from. It's got a pretty capable rich text editor, the ability to share notebooks with other people, it's got tags, the ability to save searches, and a ton of different integrations with other apps. It also features optical character recognition, which means that you can scan in images with text and it can make that text searchable. And you can also annotate images in the app as well. But for all its strengths, Evernote frustrates me, and that's primarily because you cannot create nested hierarchies of notebooks. You can do notebooks and you can do notebook stacks, but that's it. Now, some people out there, like the writer Michael Hyatt, for example, advocate using a tag-based structure to gain that hierarchy instead. But that doesn't really work because on the Evernote mobile apps, those tags are not going to show in their hierarchy. They're all alphabetical, so it kind of breaks down. Still, Evernote is incredibly powerful. It's available on basically every platform, and because of those reasons, I am continuing to use it, at least for certain parts of my workflow, even though I have many other options in 2019. Speaking of other options, let's now talk about OneNote. Microsoft OneNote is probably the closest competitor to Evernote in terms of features, as you're gonna find similar image support, optical character recognition, the ability to annotate images, and honestly, the editor area is a lot more flexible and customizable than Evernote's is. Additionally, Microsoft OneNote is free, like actually free. The only way you'd ever pay for Microsoft OneNote is if you decided to upgrade your OneDrive storage, as that's the only way they ever charge you money. They just use OneDrive for their storage. That being said, I personally just can't get into OneNote. I know a lot of people out there love it. It's incredibly powerful, which is why it's on my list, but it doesn't work for me because you cannot sort notes within your notebooks by date modified, date created, or alphabetically. You can only drag them around like they're actual note cards or pages in a notebook. And that, combined with limited tagging capabilities and the same number of organizational levels of hierarchy as you get in Evernote, you don't get more, makes OneNote kind of a no-go for me personally. That brings us over to Bear, which is an absolutely beautiful app that I wish that I could use as a daily driver in my workflow. But Bear is a Mac and iOS exclusive, and that's kind of a bummer because I also use Windows on a daily basis alongside my Mac and iPhone. That being said, if you are a Mac and iPhone only kind of person, Bear is definitely worth your consideration. This is primarily because, unlike Evernote and OneNote, Bear has a beautiful hybrid Markdown editor. And if you're not familiar with Markdown, it's a markup language that allows you to format your text as you type by putting different symbols around your text. So for example, you could put two stars around a word to bold that word. Now, a lot of Markdown editors force you to write in plain text and then you can only preview your formatted text, but Bear doesn't do that. It actually formats your text as you write, which I really, really like. Additionally, Bear also has a pretty interesting organizational system that does let you create as many levels of hierarchy as you like. And they use tags to achieve this. By typing hashtags in your document and then using slashes to create additional tags beyond it, you can create your own organizational structure. structure. Now, some people don't like having tags right in the editor window like that, but some people might not mind that. And I also have to give a shout out to their archive feature, which lets you archive notes and take them out of search and your organizational hierarchy, but not delete them. Of course, if you are an Apple exclusive kind of person, then we do have to consider Apple's own notes program, mainly because it's free. And unlike Bear, if you happen to not have access to an Apple computer at some point, or you're a part-time Windows guy like me, you can at least access your notes at iCloud.com. Now, though Apple Notes doesn't have the awesome hybrid markdown capabilities of Bear or some other apps we're gonna talk about, it does have really nice formatting tools. And to my eyes, the default formatting looks better than it does on Evernote. Additionally, yep, you guessed it, you can indeed create your own nested list of hierarchical folders. And I love that feature. Moving on to the next item on our list, we are now at Google Keep, which is a pretty nice and simple note-taking app that's available in the browser and also on pretty much all of your devices as well. Now, when I was testing Google Keep, the number one word that kept coming up to my mind was simplicity. It's a very simple note-taking app. There are simple but effective formatting options, and you can even change the background color of your notes to visually distinguish them. The problem for me, though, is that there's only one level of tags that you can create. You cannot create a hierarchical level of basically anything, so there's no hierarchical organization. So I guess if you're gonna use Google Keep as a note-taking app, you're gonna wanna rely mostly on their search function. And I guess with it being Google, that search function is probably pretty good. But that being said, since it lacks true organizational hierarchy, I don't see this as a viable alternative to Evernote or OneNote or anything more complex. But if you want a scratch pad for taking notes and setting reminders for later, Google Keep could be a good bet. That brings us over to Notion. And I know a lot of you guys were waiting for me to talk about Notion. It's definitely the app that I get the most questions about these days, and for good reason, because Notion is stupidly powerful. It's definitely the most flexible tool on this list, allowing you to lay out pages however you want, create an infinite hierarchy of organization on the sidebar, and even interlink between pages easily. It's also got a great hybrid markdown editor that's very similar to the one you're gonna find in Bear, though it does have some quirks that keep me from really loving it, such as the fact that you cannot precisely select text if it goes outside a single block of information. But my gripes about the editor aside, Notion can do things that no other app can do. And that's mainly because of the combination of a couple of different features. First, their table feature is actually a database feature. So every row in a table actually links to its own page. And secondly, they've got a templating feature that allows you to make basically anything into a template. And I've combined these two features to build Notion out into an incredibly powerful video management platform that has made our editing process so much smoother. So in one area of the app, I've got a database with all of our videos, who's sponsoring them, their publish dates, all kinds of good information like that. But if you click into any video, you'll see there's a very well laid out template that allows for us to create a B-roll database, a script, and also has some checklists that are automatically populated every single time we need to do a video. So for very complicated processes, like going through the publishing process, we can just go through that automatically generated checklist and make sure nothing gets left behind. Now, like I said, I get a lot of questions about Notion over on Twitter and on Instagram. So if you guys wanna see a more detailed Notion video on this channel, definitely let me know in the comments down below. Right now, the verdict is out on if it's a great note-taking app, but it's definitely a great organizational app in general, and it's, again, very flexible. All right, let's talk about Standard Notes. Now, Standard Notes, as far as I can tell, I could be wrong, but I think Standard Notes is the only app on my list that is developed by one single developer. Given that fact, I've got to say that I'm pretty impressed with everything the developer has been able to accomplish with this app. For one, it is easily the most security-focused app on the list, as everything you write is encrypted by default, and only you can access it. Now, you'll immediately notice that the free version of Standard Notes is just a plain text editor. There is a note browsing window, but you can't write in Markdown. There's no rich text editing. It's just plain text. But upgrade to their extended version and you get a whole bunch of extensions that you can optionally turn on or off. There are several different editors to choose from, including multiple Markdown editors, a rich text editor, and even a code editor. And this is really cool. You can choose which editor you want to use on a note by note basis. You can create custom folders with your tags, and these are infinitely nestable. And you can even define custom searches based on those tags or even other information and then save those searches within the app. Standard Notes is not perfect though. For one, the image support is kind of lacking right now as you have to host your images elsewhere to have them displayed within the app, and you also cannot drag and drop notes between different folders or tags. Still, I've got to say that I am pretty impressed with what the developer has accomplished so far. Now we are on to me taking a break and playing with this puzzle because, well, there's a lot of items on this list. All right, enough of that. Let's talk about Sleight. Sleight is, by design, a very team-focused note-taking app that could also work pretty well for a solo note-taker. It's got an absolutely fantastic hybrid Markdown editor that I found pretty similar to the one in Dropbox Paper, which allows you to format your text on the fly and also embed images and videos and even tables. I'm also a big fan of their table of contents view, which lets you quickly zoom to different headings within your note. And this is something you'll find in Google Docs and Dropbox Paper, and it's something we even built into the articles in the latest version of College Info Geek, but it's very rare to find in a note-taking app, so props to Sleight for including it. Now, Sleight also allows you to create a nested hierarchy of notes within the app so you can organize things, though the way they implement it is kind of weird, because on one side you've got channels, and then within the middle part of the app, that's where you can create these collections which are infinitely nestable. The only problem is that you can only sort by recency on a channel level, so their sorting options are a little less powerful than other apps can offer you. Now, much like Notion, Sleight is built primarily for teams, so you can collaboratively edit a document with somebody in real time, and there's also this great comment section that puts comments in a nice little window to the side of your editor, and I really like that. Sleight is also available on mobile apps and on the web and on basically every platform out there, so at least from a design perspective, it seems to be one of the best note-taking apps that I could actually find when doing the research for this video. My main gripe with it right now, at least right now, is the experience of using it, because it can be slow at times, and I've also run into some bugs where the text actually isn't formatted after I've put the formatting tags around it. That being said, Sleight is a pretty new company, and I do have to admit that when I tested a few months ago, it was much slower than it is now, so they're making big improvements, and I'm gonna be keeping an eye on the team's progress going forward. But that is talk about the future, and we are living in the present. And at present, in my opinion, the note-taking app with the best organizational structure of them all is our ninth app on the list, Ulysses. Now, Ulysses is often billed as an app for serious novelists and writers, but I think it can also work really well as a note-taking app. And that's because primarily it has that amazing organizational system that I just alluded to. Not only can you create a nested hierarchy of as many folders as you want, but when you go into a top-level folder, you're able to see the notes within subfolders along with notes in that top level folder as well, and I love that. Additionally, you can define sorting options for every single folder in the app. You can create custom searches, you can do tags, there's an archive view, there's an inbox view, there's a favorites view, there's recency views. Ulysses basically has it all, and I absolutely love it. The biggest bummer is, just like Bear, it's only on Mac and iOS platforms, so I can't use it unless I want to just totally give up my Windows PC as a writing device. So that leads us to this question. What is a guy who uses a Windows computer and a Mac computer on a daily basis and who really wants a great writing experience to do? Well, in my case, the answer is to use the last app on our list, which is TypeAra. TypeAra is a desktop writing app that has the best writing experience I've ever had next to Dropbox Paper. It's got that hybrid Markdown writing system that automatically formats your writing as you type. It's much faster than Sleight, and unlike Bear, again, it's on Windows along with Mac and even Linux. It's also full of features for serious writers, like a focus mode that dims the text that you're not currently working on, a table of contents mode for zooming between your outline headings, just like in Sleight, and themes, lots and lots of themes, which you can customize with CSS if you want. However, there are some caveats. Like I said, TypeAra is a desktop writing app. There is no mobile app right now, which is kind of a bummer. The other thing is that TypeAra almost didn't make my list because, unlike everything else that I've talked about, it doesn't actually store or sync your notes itself. It's purely a Markdown editor. The reason it still fits my definition of a note-taking app is because of its file browser. Once you've opened up a folder in the app, you can easily drill down into all the subfolders and open up as many documents as you want. But again, the biggest downside here is the lack of a good mobile app. Now, I don't really care too much about this since I'm really only using TypeAra for serious writing, for like finishing articles or video scripts, but if you really need to access your TypeAra documents, remember they are just Markdown files within your folder system on your computer. So if you're using Dropbox or Google Drive, then you can get a Markdown editor for your iPhone or Android that can access those cloud platforms such as IA Writer. So now it is time to come to a verdict. Which app on this list wins? Honestly, it is pretty hard to come to a definitive conclusion on this because everyone has different features they want, different needs, different devices they use, different budgets. So instead of just recommending one app, I'm gonna name some winners in a few different categories, and then it's up to you to choose. For the actual writing experience, again, the win goes to TypeAra. Sleight is also pretty good, but I'm waiting for it to become a little less buggy and a little more snappy. So I'm gonna be keeping my eye on that and using TypeAra in the meantime. For note organization, the win goes to Ulysses. Again, with infinitely nestable folders and tags and custom searches, really nothing else out there beats it, at least in my eyes. For overall capability and my general recommendation, I still have to give the win to Evernote. Yeah, it doesn't have Markdown support, which I really, really want along with those nestable folders, but otherwise it's got a ton of capabilities. Though I do have to say that Notion in particular is really nipping at the heels of Evernote in the capability department, and if you care more about those database and templating features, then you might actually think it's more capable. Now, I do want to make one last note here. With all these devices and apps and capabilities we have, it can be really easy to overcomplicate things. Because if you're anything like me, having all these capabilities makes it very tempting to try to do too much. And that's why I am once again listening to Greg McKeown's excellent book, Essentialism: The Disciplined Pursuit of Less. This was one of my favorite books from 2017, and it's one that, at least for me, is worth returning to because it has great advice for figuring out how to narrow down your focuses in life. And honestly, this is one of the areas where I tend to struggle the most. Now, if you also want to get more focused with your priorities and you want to start digging into essentialism, then you are in luck because you can start listening to it for free today on Audible. All you need to do is go over to audible.com/Thomas or text Thomas to 500-500 on your phone, and you can download that audiobook or any audiobook of your choosing for free, and you're also going to get a free 30-day trial of their service as well. And once you start that trial, you are quickly going to find out that Audible is the best place to get audiobooks on the entire internet. They have an unmatched selection of audiobook titles across tons of different genres, including biographies and psychology and sci-fi. And once you download an audiobook, it is yours to keep forever, regardless of whether or not you cancel. You're always going to be able to listen to it across all of your devices. So if you want to gain the ability to learn new things wherever you are, whatever you're doing, whether it's going on a long bike ride or cooking or doing chores, then once again, go over to audible.com/Thomas or text Thomas to 500-500 on your phone to get that free audiobook download and a free 30-day trial of their service. Big thanks as always to Audible for sponsoring this video and being a supporter of the channel. And as always, guys, thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you got a lot of value out of this video. Hopefully you've got something that you can go try out now. And if you enjoyed this video, definitely hit that like button and subscribe right there as well to get new videos when they come out every single week. You can also click right there to get a free copy of my book on how to earn better grades. Follow me on Instagram at Tom Frankly, or click right over here or smash your face into your phone screen to get one more video on this channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.